Former First Gentleman Jose Miguel Mike Arroyo will no longer face a graft charge over his alleged role in the purchase by the Philippine National Police of secondhand helicopters in 2009. That's after a Supreme Court division granted his motion for reconsideration, questioning his inclusion in the case. In a resolution dated December 1, 2021, but released only on April 10 this year, the SC Special Third Division ruled there was no probable cause to charge Arroyo of violating Section 3E of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. The section punishes those causing undue injury to the government or giving any private party unwarranted benefits. Arroyo was accused of helping negotiate the sale of two choppers he owned to the Philippine National Police, despite the National Police Commission's requirement to only buy brand new choppers. In an affidavit, Lion Air owner Archibald Poe claimed he helped Arroyo purchase the choppers from the manufacturer in 2003 and later helped sell it to the PNP through another corporation in 2009. The proceeds, worth around $450,000 for each chopper, supposedly went to Arroyo. Arroyo denied the allegations, saying he was not the owner, and pointed to his deceased brother's company, Lourdes de Arroyo Incorporation, or LTA, as the one who entered into a transaction with the manufacturer. The Supreme Court Special Third Division sided with Arroyo, saying the prosecution failed to establish reasonable belief that Arroyo connived with public officers in procuring the choppers. It faulted the ombudsman and the Sandigan Bayan for assuming that LTA and Mike Arroyo are one and the same, when Arroyo had supposedly divested his LTA shares, and rejected Arroyo and family's frequent use of the choppers as evidence of ownership. The resolution was penned by recently retired Supreme Court Magistrate Rosemary Carandam and concurred in by Justices Rodel Zalameda, Mario Lopez, and Samuel Gerlan, the very same justices who in January 2020 voted with Justice Marvick Leonin to junk Arroyo's petition. In the January 27, 2020 decision penned by Leonin, the same division found no grave abuse of discretion on the part of the Sandigan Bayan and Ombudsman in the exercise of their prerogatives, saying the Supreme Court will not interfere with the findings of probable cause. It is the same reasoning Leonin reiterated in his dissenting opinion to the recent ruling, pointing out that the Ombudsman, in the exercise of his executive function, and the Sandigan Bayan, exercising his judicial function, both found probable cause to charge Arroyo and to proceed to trial. Leonin added, misappreciation of facts alone does not amount to grave abuse of discretion, and even considering the facts of the case, there is reasonable belief that Arroyo was involved in the anomalous sale as the owner of the helicopters. Mike Navallo, ABS-CBN News.